You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Tuesday, February 4th, 2020. This week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are talking about the sacrament of marriage. We've already talked about how God established marriage, how that marriage is a sign to the world of the way God loves us. Now, today we are going to talk about the nitty-gritty of what needs to happen before and during a marriage. So first, let's talk about the requirements that a marriage is actually a sacrament. Because remember, we talked about yesterday that people can go to a courthouse and get a legal marriage, but there's nothing sacramental about it. It's sure a beautiful way to tell someone you love them, but it's not a sacrament through which God's grace flows. So in order for a marriage to be sacramental, the following three things have to be true. Number one, both the husband and the wife need to freely consent, meaning you can't be forced into a marriage. The next requirement is that both the husband and the wife freely and knowingly make a lifetime commitment to each other and only to each other. When you get married, you can't be interested in anyone else. It has to be saying to this other person, you will be my only love, my only spouse for my whole life. The third and final requirement for a marriage to be a sacrament is that both the husband and the wife need to be open to children. Now, maybe you know a husband and wife that really, really want a baby, but for some reason, they just can't seem to get pregnant and have a baby. Now, that's fine. This is God's will for some reason that we don't understand. But when they get married, you do both have to say, we will accept and welcome any children that God decides to send us. Now, perhaps you have been to a wedding before and you've seen the various parts of a wedding. We are just going to review some of the basic things that happen in every Catholic wedding. So the first thing is that the Catholic wedding has to be public, meaning you don't have to invite everyone in the world, but it has to be done in public, not in private. And this is important because a marriage is something that you will live in the world. It's not a secret between two people. It's a public declaration that we are uniting our lives. Now, at the beginning of a marriage ceremony, perhaps it's part of a mass or not, but the priest or deacon will question the husband and wife about their intention. Next, the deacon or priest will bless the rings that the husband and wife will wear. Next, the husband and wife mutually promise each other to be true. And perhaps you've heard this before. You promise to be true in good times and in bad times, in sickness and in health. Next, the husband and wife make a vow or a promise to each other, a very deep promise that they will love and honor each other all the days of their lives. They exchange rings. Oftentimes, there's a part of the mass that comes in, and finally, the priest or deacon says a blessing. Now, all of these parts are important, and they are important because they are done in public. A marriage is publicly declaring to the church, because remember, as Catholics, we are married in the church. We're declaring that our marriage will be part of this faith community, that we are here to share our lives not only with each other as husband and wife, but as part of this larger faith community. Now, there is a lot that happens unseen during the sacrament of marriage, just as is true with all of the other sacraments. But for today, what I want you to do is I want you to turn to the adult that is with you. And if they are married, I want you to ask them questions about their own wedding day, what they wore, if it was part of a mass, what they thought, what it felt like, all of those things. If you don't happen to be with someone who is married, then you can just reminisce about the various weddings that you have witnessed. And as you talk about these things, remember all of the various things we talked about today that made this wedding not only beautiful, but made it a sacrament. That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be. Well, it is a big week for Catholic Sprouts. We just launched all of our family adoration materials. There is a board book for little ones, a coloring book, a children's journal, a parent's guide, and so much more. Feel free to come over and check it out and get inspired to bring your whole family to Eucharistic adoration. You can click the link in the notes for this podcast episode or simply head to catholicsprouts.com/adoration.